that flies through the air. You may tramp the world over, but none can compare to the bright of old Craigan and Donny White Hair. One clean out the morning, as you may suppose, the red golden sun or the green mountain rose. Barney Conway came down and he did declare, but today I'll put an end to the Craigan White Hair. So he searched through the lowlands and down through the glens, all among the wild ditches where the white hair thins. Till at last, coming over the bog bank so fair, from behind the wild thistle out jumped the white hair. Well, he gave a great yelp and his dogs he slipped to, as swift as the wind or the green mountain flew. But the dog soon came back, which made Barbary sigh, for he knew that the white hare had bid him goodbye. We have some jolly sportsmen down from the Pomeroy, from Kutchtown, Dungannon, and likewise the boy. With their pedigree greyhounds, they travelled afar, came down to Craigan in a fine motor car. Huntsmen did go in search of the white hare, they tried high and low. Till at last Barney Conway, as he came on its lair, shouted out to the huntsmen, "Here lies the white hare." So they called up their greyhound up from the green lea, and Barney and the huntsmen all jumped high with glee. Legs and raised one big ear. Oh, she stood on her toes and with one gallant spring, she cleared all the greyhounds and broke through the ring. There came another man and you all know him well. His name is Pat Devlin of Bunny Black and Nell. In search of the white hair, he says, "I'll have fun. My black bell does her turn. Five turns the hair got from Bunny Black and Nell. The sixth one was given round John Hockey's well. 'Twas there we lost sight of the hair and the dog. Then 10 minutes later they came o'er the bog." My rhyme, I hope you'll excuse me for wasting your time. If there's any amongst you in Carrickmore Fair, drink a bonny well health to the Craigan.